We now know who will be on the ballot for governor. Thanks for watching Bobcat Update. I'm Evan Dennis.
And I'm Denim Pittman. We'll also tell you what's been done about contaminated water and concerns in San Marcos. This November's race for governor is now set. It'll be Governor Rick Perry versus Bill White. Perry avoided runoff last night after last night's Republican primary, defeating Senator Kay Bailey Hutchinson and businesswoman Deborah Medina. Perry is now going after his third full four-year term in office. Meanwhile, White, the former mayor of Houston, easily beat businessman Farouk Shami in last night's Democratic primary. White told supporters Texas deserves a governor who isn't looking for his own political interests.
Primary races were also held here in Hays County. One of the biggest races is for sheriff. Incumbent Tommy Ratliff won the Democratic primary last night. He'll now face Republican Gary Cutler in November. Newcomers Jeff Barton and Bart Cobb also won their primaries in the battle for Hays County judge. Voters will decide on all of these races on November 2nd.
Austin Community College wants to bring a campus and more courses to San Marcos residents. Laura Crouch has more.
Last Thursday at the San Marcos Public Library, San Marcos Access held an information session to begin a petition drive for residents to become part of the Austin Community College taxing district. The move would allow an ACC campus to be built in San Marcos. If 5% of registered voters are in favor of the annexation, then San Marcos residents will vote in November whether to be a part of the ACC taxing district.
We're trying to get San Marcos to join the ACC district because it'll bring a full campus here, lower tuition from $139 a semester hour to $30 a semester hour.
The ACC Center at San Marcos High School offers a limited number of courses. If ACC establishes a permanent campus in San Marcos, then the course offerings would increase. ACC student Josh Gomez, who's taking classes at the San Marcos Center, is in favor of the annexation.
I mean, it's a tax, yeah, but some things are kind of necessary for things to get better. So I think it'd be okay. I wouldn't have a problem with it.
Tommy Luna says an ACC campus would benefit Texas State students too.
Some of the things that ACC can offer for us are cheaper summer classes so that we don't have to pay as much as we take them at Texas State. And then also the ability to get additional certifications to make us more marketable.
If enough signatures are collected and the vote goes through, the new campus will be located off Highway 123 right near the high school. For Bobcat Update, I'm Laura Crouch.
The San Marcos Municipal Airport will soon get money from the state for some needed improvements. $530,000 has been approved from TxDOT's Aviation Facilitation Grant Program. A contract should be finalized this spring so work can begin. The improvements will include new fencing. The San Marcos Airport isn't the only one waiting for these improvement funds. About 275 community airports are eligible to receive funds from TxDOT's pool of $60 million.
Texas State students looking for a good time at a cheap price will be pleased to hear that several San Marcos bars and restaurants have a solution. Caitlin Irwin has more in this Bobcat Update.
In today's struggling economy, bars and restaurants are finding new ways to fill their tables. A nationwide trend is to create or extend happy hour schedules. The manager of San Marcos restaurant Palmer's says the clientele during happy hour is about 80% students.
We get pretty busy between the hours of 3 and 6, which is our happy hour. Less expensive.
Some bars, however, are finding it easy to maintain a steady flow of patrons. For example, the tap room is as busy as ever.
You know, people drink in bad times, people drink in good times. You know, it's not, I wouldn't say that that's, you know, saying that people are, you know, that alcoholism goes up during times of woe, but people are going to come out and try to socialize no matter, you know, what their money's like.
Happy hours around San Marcos bring students out, and as the prices go down, it's bottoms up. For Bobcat Update, I'm Caitlin Irwin.
Firefighters in Dallas yesterday had a battle on their hands. It took about 3 hours and dozens of firefighters to bring this fire under control at a strip mall. The fire left behind the charred skeletons of four popular downtown bars and restaurants. Officials say one firefighter was taken to the hospital for smoke inhalation, but he was okay. No one was in the building this morning when it started just after dawn. Investigators are looking into what might have started that fire.
No Texas State Bobcat would likely want to tangle with this guy, an actual Bobcat. The real deal was found in Houston, a garage, of all places, probably hungry and looking for food. Animal control officers were called to the scene to grab him and return him to the wild. One worker thought the big cat was just a larger version of a house pet until she saw it stretched out underneath a vehicle. It took 2 shots from a tranquilizer gun to subdue it. The bobcat was checked out by a vet and released. Bobcats rarely hang out in heavily populated areas.
Coming up, a Texas State professor with ties to Chile talks about the devastating earthquake there.
That's next on Bobcat Update.
San Marcos River Foundation is a nonprofit organization that aims to protect and clean the San Marcos River since 1985. It is run by a small group of San Marcos citizens and riverside landowners. Members of the foundation work year-long to maintain the natural flow of the river and provide a healthy environment for the river wildlife. The foundation sponsors river cleanups and educational events to inform the San Marcos community about the water quality, testing, preserving plant life, and ways you can help protect the natural beauty of the river. The efforts of the San Marcos River Foundation make it possible for the river to be a clean and safe place for people to enjoy popular recreational activities. Interest in volunteering or making a donation is always encouraged, and for more information on upcoming events, how you can become a member, or the history of the San Marcos River Foundation, go to their website at sanmarcosriver.org.
3 days after the devastating earthquake struck Chile, the country is still reeling from the frequent and powerful aftershocks. One strong tremor was felt yesterday during a police news conference in the town of Concepcion. Cameras were rolling on a group of rescue workers as the building the crew was searching began to shake. Rescuers quickly jumped from a hole carved into the side of the 15-story building where some people are feared trapped. Some people at Texas State have been affected in a personal way by the earthquake in Chile. Alex Herring has more on the story.
The death toll is approaching 800 and expected to climb after an earthquake and tsunami left many Chilean cities in rubble.
The news is especially sad for those who spent time in Chile or have other connections there. Piano professor Washington Garcia says he loves Chile with its rich history and art. Years ago, he performed for Chile's president.
The culture itself and the place, I mean, fantastic landscapes to see, you know, all the mountains. And it was truly an experience that I would never forget.
Garcia says he hopes Texas State will be involved in the relief effort.
And it was very bad when I heard what had happened in Chile, because of all the memories that I have, but also because of friends that I still have and keep in touch with.
Some students have plans to study in Chile, and so far, they'll still be able to. The university's study abroad director, Isis Gomez, says a student will be going to Chile's capital next week. Gomez says the summer program will also continue.
Now, according to the latest results, the Chilean president has dispatched 14,000 troops to help with the distribution of aid. This will be especially useful in those coastal towns where the tsunami hit the hardest. For Bobcat Update, I'm Alex Herring. Back to you, Evan.
Thanks, Alex. The San Marcos water is free of E. coli again after the second testing of a contaminated well came back clear. Jessica Peters has more in this Bobcat Update.
The San Marcos Public Services Division each month tests more than 60 water distribution sites, and this past Thursday, a well at Spring Lake tested positive for E. coli. Bacterium like E. coli is common in the environment and in raw water supply sources. According to biology professor Bob McLean, E. coli is found in humans and actually assists in keeping one's digestive tract healthy. He says in water, there's no more E. coli than any other organism.
Different. Fish, turtles, whatever, feel the call of nature, so they're going to introduce a bit of E. coli into it.
After the discovery of the E. coli bacteria, the well was immediately deactivated until the water quality could be assured.
There is no E. coli in the drinking water in the distribution system. This sample was taken from one of our wells, and this was a raw, untreated sample that was taken, and it did show E. coli positive.
Public services flush the well twice to provide fresh water and restore water quality. The second water sample was taken on Monday, and the results found no traces of E. coli in the raw water.
The Spring Lake well is up and running again, and our water is E. coli free. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jessica Peters.
A convicted murder's execution date has been set. According to the Austin American-Statesman, David Lee Powell will be put to death on June 16th. Back in 1978, Powell opened fire on a police with an AK-47 after his girlfriend had been pulled over. On
An officer was hit 10 times and died. At the time, Powell was a student at the University of Texas. Powell's attorney is upset by this week's court order and believes that Travis County should do away with the death penalty, saying it is wrong. However, the victim's son says the process has been more than fair.
Several highway projects and jobless benefits will resume in Texas after the Senate reached an agreement to end a filibuster. Senator Jim Bunning had held up the $10 billion in benefits for several days. The Kentucky Republican said he didn't oppose extending the programs, he just didn't want to add to the federal deficit. The Senate voted 78-19 to extend the measures for 30 days. Highway monies were immediately released, which means about 2,000 transportation workers returned to their jobs today after President Obama signed the bill.
Ford Motors has driven ahead of Toyota and General Motors to claim the sales in the U.S. amid a growing number of recalls. Toyota reports a 9% drop in the U.S. General Motors has had a rebound in sales with an increase of 12% over a year ago. Ford, meanwhile, sold 43% more cars in the U.S. last month than in the same month a year ago. The automaker also reported that sales jumped in January, even though Northeastern dealers were buried under the snow.
An Austin attorney is in hot water with a judge here in Hays County after failing to show up to court one too many times. According to the Austin American-Statesman, Edmund Skip Davis didn't show up for a murder trial where he was the defense attorney. The judge then ordered him to show up on Monday to explain why, but Davis again didn't show up. This isn't the first time Davis has been in trouble. He was previously charged with contempt of court in Austin, where he agreed to pay a fine and do community service.
No Saturday delivery of the mail. That's an idea being kicked around by the U.S. Postal Service to save money. Another way that will go into effect later this year is a reduction in workforce. About 30,000 positions will be eliminated through attrition and early retirement offers. Officials, though, believe the layoffs might not be enough. The Postal Service lost $4 billion last year. To cut the overhead even further, the Postal Service is floating the idea of eliminating Saturday service.
Patent infringements are causing some problem for smartphone retailers. Apple has filed a complaint against the Taiwanese smartphone vendor HTC, claiming that the company is infringing 20 Apple patents related to the phone's interface and hardware. Apple is also seeking to prevent U.S. imports of HTC phones in order to curb sales. According to an HTC spokesperson, the lawsuit struck them by surprise when they heard about this via media reports this morning. HTC is investigating the validity of Apple's claims. The suit was filed in federal district court in Delaware.
A new Chick-fil-A opens its doors in San Marcos tomorrow at 6 in the morning. But the crowds are already camping out because of the first 100 people to enter the restaurant will receive a year's of worth of free meals. The new Chick-fil-A is going in at I-35 and Wonder World Drive, right in front of the Lowe's. The only other Chick-fil-A in town is on campus at the LBJ Student Center, and it is the busiest Chick-fil-A in the entire Southwest United States.
The annual South by Southwest Festival will be a little different this year for Texas State University. The festival is usually held during the university's spring break, but that won't be the case this year. Spring break is next week, which is earlier than it usually is, and won't be coinciding with South by Southwest. The reason? Texas State will be hosting representatives of a major accrediting organization during the same week as South by Southwest. Since classes and the festival's schedule overlap, students will have to make some tough decisions. I know that tomorrow we're going to be covering more on that South by Southwest.
Sounds good. Tune in next time tomorrow for information on Texas State students at South by Southwest. That's all in this edition of Bobcat Update. Thanks for watching.
We'll be back tomorrow afternoon at 4:30. See you then.